So we're here in Clovis, California, and we just finished installing this closet flange. The homeowner took the old or the existing toilet off, and when they got down to the floor, they had used, in the past, they had used a repair bracket, which is this guy right there, over top of an old white, old PVC plastic flange. And what had happened with the original one is it got over tightened and it snapped off a whole section on the right hand side. So approximately this much of the flange was gone, including the part where you put the bolt. So what we did is we just went and got a repair flange and glued it in here. We had to cut out, obviously, or maybe not obviously to you, but to me, that flange, we had to cut it all the way out and demo it back down to concrete. We got it hogged out pretty good, all the way down to bare concrete. Down here you can see, you know, all the way around, the flange is sitting down on that. And so cut the plastic down, and then of course there's all the leftover glue, and plumbers glue this stuff on there. That glue just runs down inside the pipe, and they don't wipe it out. Why should they? It doesn't matter. I've seen it actually grab a hold of debris. That dried up glue will form a little polyp or little piece sticking out, and toilet paper and other stuff will grab onto that and start to build up. So when I glue these down originally, I wipe out the inside of the pipe. Just one rag, one wipe, glue's gone. And so anyways, no big deal. Took a file and filed out everything, and utility knife, cut things out, sandpaper, sanded it out. Spent quite a bit of time getting in there and getting the inside of the riser, the soil pipe, it's 4-inch PVC. Getting that cleaned out, because this pipe glues inside of, or this flange glues inside of that pipe, so it's got to be perfectly clean. So we got it all good, and you can see we're down on cement right here. So glued it in, primer, glue, set it down, then of course we got some Tapcon anchor bolts, those are 2 1/4, drilled it out. The concrete was real good around here. This looks like the flange originally was poured in place, as opposed to most plumbers, though. They'll wrap the soil pipe coming through real big, and then after the pour, they'll pull the foam wrap out, glue the flange down, then fill it back in with the mortar, which is not a great base. But this felt like solid concrete all the way down. So you've got 6 screws all the way around. 6 holes, 6 screws. And so it's mounted to the floor. That's code. It's supposed to be mounted. And then also glued into the old pipe, which is solid. I mean, it's in there. I don't, you know, get this thing out, you'd have to jackhammer for days. So anyways, it's in there. Point of courtesy, we put in some new closet bolts just because the old ones were, you know, corroded and whatnot. So those are in. The trick here on this is do not over tighten the toilet. You know, snug it up until it hits floor. If you've got uneven tile, then shim it, you know, be very gentle with it, because it is PVC pipe. And it's a little more brittle than ABS pipe. And, you know, so if you over tighten it, you can snap that. And you don't want that, because after this repair, the next repair, I'm not sure what they could do. And I've seen a lot of guys, they'll take a little stainless steel flange and cap the top of this off, and then just put little shorty screws into the plastic and tap. It's about a 1/2 inch thick. And then just tap it and screw it into the flange all the way around, and that becomes their new mounting point. I don't like that, but anyway, so that is in. They may have us come back and set the toilet. We don't reinstall old supply lines just because they've been in place for a while, and you know that usually in there is already, you know, pretty well worn, and we don't want to put it back together and then have a flooded bathroom because we used an old supply line that cost $6 over at Home Depot. So we'll get with them, see what they want to do. You know, glue's drying. You could probably set it right now, mainly because those bolts are pretty good. You know, I drove them in there, and they snugged up real good, so you're good to go. And then, of course, if you do set it yourself, make sure you use enough wax. On the first wax ring, I would use either like a double extra thick, you know, like a reinforced wax ring that has the horn on it. It's a little black flange that kind of sits down into the toilet there and diverts the water into the soil pipe as a base. If it's only a single thickness, great, but you're going to need either a double, like a, you know, a double thick horned wax ring put it on there, and then it should seal, or you'll need two rings. Just a single ring. It's the thinner. You know, they don't have a flange on them, and they're not real thick. They're, you know, they're like that thick of wax. So get a horned one on the bottom, another single on the top, and just squish it down there and make sure that it really seats, because what you're trying to do is the top of that flange, you're trying to get the wax to indent all the way around and smash down on it enough to where it completely encapsulates that and seals it. And then also, same thing up against the bottom of the toilet, you want that wax to smash up in there, and it forms a good seal, so you don't get any sewer gases coming out, you know, from around the perimeter, even though it's going to be caulked in. So anyways, this installation is done. Outside of that, we are good.